Modern Warfare 3 picks up at the end of Modern Warfare 2, where Russia has invaded the East Coast of the United States, as you remember, has wiped out Washington, D.C., and the U.S. is really scrambling to drive them out. So SOPA Captain Price, two characters that you've known and loved from Modern 2, reappear with a new band of heroes in the Special Ops Force Delta in the United States, as well as Special Ops globally, as this becomes a global allied conflict against the Russians. So you'll play with the SAS, with GIGN, and with Special Operations Forces around the world. The battles begin in the harbor of New York City as we push Russia out, and it becomes really a fully global experience. So you have battles in Paris, in Berlin, in London, in Africa, in Prague, across the world. As you know, Modern 2 was a phenomenal game, and we're building on the shoulders of greatness there. So we've been able to add technology and innovation to the engine and really push the hardware as far as it can go. We're excited about that, and I think this year, more than ever, we're really taking advantage of everything it has to offer. We're talking about multiplayer later this year, so I can't give you any specifics now, except hopefully you're going to get a chance to see the Elite presentation and the integration there. There's a lot of really great stuff going on. Elite's going to integrate with Modern Warfare 3 in a way that is going to bring connectivity, social media, competition, and the ability to improve in ways that we've never had before. So I think that's going to be exciting. And then more on the multiplayer specific later this summer. You know, motion control is one of those peripheries that I think everyone wants to try and incorporate in a way that's additive to the game experience, right? If it can make it so that our players enjoy the experience in a new and unique way, we'd love to be able to do that. You don't want to just try and incorporate it for the sake of saying you incorporated it, but look, all the hardware providers are doing really innovative stuff. Microsoft, Sony, Nintendo. So, you know, we want to also innovate in everything we can, and if the opportunity presents itself to bring those together, that'd be great. We're always pushing ways off the player something new. So you're gonna have new weapons, new epic urban warfare on scales you've never seen in Call of Duty before. There's gonna be new mechanics, new modes in Spec Ops and multiplayer. So there's a ton that we're excited to show you that I think the gamers are gonna love. This year, you're gonna play right around the corner here, Spec Ops Survival Mode. Spec Ops Survival Mode is a single player or a co-op experience where you are battling waves of enemies, upgrading your character, and fighting for as long as you can against increasingly difficult waves of enemies. We're real focused on making authentic urban warfare. One of the things you'll see today in our live demos is the XM25, which is an experimental new weapon that the military is putting into action today. So the players, in fact, will be able to play this XM25 called the Punisher before our troops actually have it on the battlefield. So look for that. It's an exciting new way to battle in New York, which you're going to see and across the campaign. As you recall from Modern 2, we presented Spec Ops mission modes in a way that would take you back to familiar locations, but played out in new and unique ways. And of course, we're bringing that back. It's a common misconception that Modern 3 is a trilogy. Modern 3 is a continuation of the story from Modern 2. And it's exciting. We're bringing back all the heroes you know, and we're taking them on new adventures around the world. However, we're not calling it a trilogy. Modern Warfare 3 comes to global release November 8th, 2011 on the PS3, the 360, and the PC.